got a pair coming all the way out here to save your sister. Too bad there's no way out.
That's what you think.
Thank you.
crush you like a bug! Go get him, tiger!
Not bad.
I feel stronger than before!
There's still plenty of power left in these old bones.
Conqueror! Duke
Amion's plan has failed. There is no reason to fight. Call back your troops.
You know you can use your precious remnant to wipe us out and prove Athlum's strength to the world. The battle has just begun. Let us enjoy it.
You wish to continue this nonsense?
It's useless. They don't get what we're saying. He plays by his own rules.
He's almost there.
Ruace, Castanea, finish this.
Yes, sir!
You're strong. But I...
Rat!
I can't lose this fight!
Yes, the truth is inside you. Remember your true self.
Marion's blessing.
Thus, half a year passed. After taking control of the Congress, the newly appointed Chairman Gore deemed Lord Wilfred M. Iron a casualty of war. The official story was that after the Conqueror killed M. Iron, the Conqueror's forces were destroyed in the subsequent fighting. Without an army to fight, the war was over. However, the scars left from the war had cut deeper than we'd thought. Violence erupted around the world, and the Lords, frustrated from the abundance of futile efforts, devised the ultimate plan. The Remnant's powers were to be used to suppress the violence. Suddenly, the Remnants meant to protect the people were being used against them. However, the Duke of Gore did not accept this. The people had placed their trust in the Congress, he said, and it was their duty to repay that trust. Thanks to Chairman Gore's efforts, things finally began to change. He declared that we had to uncover new remnants, something for the people to put their trust into. The Congress spread his message to the people. Their hearts were moved and the violence subsided. A new age was dawning, one without the horrors of war. At least that's what we all believed.